Hey folks, today we're gonna vibe code an app with Cursor and deploy it immediately straight from the chat with Defang's new MCP server. One thing I wanna be super clear about with this is that what we're doing here is tying in Defang's rules-based, scalable, stable, secure deployment tool into your AI workflow. So we're not using any AI to try and decide what infrastructure to deploy with. And there's no chance of hallucinations. We're tying into your AI-enabled development workflows to make it easy to deploy what your AI builds for you locally. With that out of the way, let's get started. First thing we're gonna do is run npx defang at latest MCP setup client cursor. So you have to have npx installed, but I think a lot of you will have it, so that should be okay. And you'll see that it updates this mcp.json file. So we're going to restart, reload window should be enough. And let's just check out our cursor settings. And in mcp, you should see defang in there. So that should be good to go. All right. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open up the chat, and I've got a prompt already set up here. So give me one second. Okay, here's my prompt. I find that with these tools, it's these AI coding assistants, it's really useful to give them a lot of context, a lot of detail, especially if you know what you're going to be deploying, and you understand how it should work, just add as much stuff in there as possible. The context windows are quite large these days, so you can just shove a lot of information in there. So what I want to generate today is a Flask app that has an endpoint that generates an image based off of some text that I send it. This is useful for like sharing images, you know, the kind of image that you see when you share on Twitter or Facebook or LinkedIn or whatever. I've given it some information about the colors that I want, the font that I want to use. I noticed in my initial tests that it had a little bit of trouble with the directory that the font should be installed to, so I've specified that. I've also told it what port and some dependencies that I want it to use, some stuff to make it production ready. I've also told it that it needs to add a health check, which returns I'm okay, and to use curl and install curl. We're also asking it to set everything up to run production ready. So no dev servers, nothing like that. That's because we want to run it in the cloud. I'm also going to ask it to test everything with Docker Compose once it's ready. After all of this runs, we're going to deploy it straight from the chat. I'm going to switch into agent mode here, and let's get going. Okay, let's let it run this build command. Oh, actually, it's also running up. That should make sense. I guess it's going to test it locally. Okay, once it hits this point, let's move it to background and allow it to run that. Cool, cool. All right, so generated an image. Let's see. Yep, that looks good. Okay, let's just say deploy it with defang, please. Okay. Gonna run that login command. And we're going to let it run that deploy command. You can set it up. You can use YOLO mode to just let it run whatever it wants. I'm not there yet. I still have to choose what it actually runs. Yeah. If we click on this current image build, in a minute here, we should see some build logs come through. You can also run this and it'll check in on the status. Okay, so I'm seeing here that things seem to be up and running. Defang will go through a few health checks before it actually marks the status of the service as healthy. So we'll just wait for that. All right, our service is healthy. Let's ask Cursor to check in. Let me check the status. If the service is healthy, can you give me a URL to test the image generation that says Defang MCP is awesome. So it'll check if that service is good to go. Then here we go. So sometimes these links are clickable, sometimes they are not. In this case, I'm just gonna copy it and I'm going to paste it. And it looks like it downloaded it. So there we go, Defang MCP is awesome. Now, the next thing I think is pretty neat is deploying an update. So let's make the gradient green and deploy the update. Okay, run tool. And so you can see this is back down and it's about to rebuild. Alrighty, that is green now. So let's try that URL again and should download a new image. There we go, that easy. So I hope this showed you how powerful it can be to use these AI assistants, and specifically how powerful it is to tie Defang's MCP server into your workflows. So you can really quickly push out updates, deploy, bring down your services, and even integrate that information that the MCP server can provide into your development workflows. I can imagine things we could do with logs and other stuff to make sure that anything that's failing in production, you can bring down that context and let your AI agents use that information to help update your configurations. I think it's a really, really exciting future. So come along with us and show us what you build. We'd love to hear it in the comments. Thanks, and see you in the next one.